Welcome back to the second video of the 20th module. We are going to discuss about the use of Adlerian principles in the consultation process of school counseling. In the modern era, the school counselors must find an effective way to deal with the students. Time is not as before and everything is changing and fast moving. Morals and values of school students also change with the time. So, the school counselors must learn and use appropriate applications in the school that assist in meeting the students' needs and developing the potential of the student. In the present day situation, Adlerian principles have been found to be effective in dealing with issues related to schools. Adlerian theory serves as a basis for working in schools since Alfred Adler first introduced them in the early 900s and they still have useful applications today. At the end of the video, the learners will be enabled to know about the Adlerian theory and to understand the key concepts related to Adlerian theory. Adlerian principles denote the psychological practices built on the belief that as unique individuals, people should be validated, connected, and to be made feel significant. Adlerian counseling focuses on the entire individuals and not just the parts that need improvement, and regards the personality as strongly influenced by the role one plays within their family of origin, which is reflected in part by their birth order. Adlerian psychology is a psycho-counseling approach based upon the work of pioneer Alfred Adler. Adler is often considered one of the big three founders of psycho-counseling along with Sigmund Freud and Carl Jung. His individual psychology approach has been adopted in many areas of counseling, education, and community work. While Adler is not as well known as Jung or Freud, his contribution to psychology and counseling are invaluable. Alfred Adler, who was an ophthalmologist before he entered psychiatry, created his principles in the early 900s after parting ways with Sigmund Freud. Much of his principles is based on the importance of having a sense of community. According to Adler, individuals who feel that they belong will act cooperatively and form healthy, loving bonds with others. But those who feel like outcasts will act out to express their feeling of inadequacy. Thus, an essential goal is to help those who feel like outsiders to create a community. Adler was the first theorist to emphasize the fundamental social nature of people. According to him, people are inherently motivated to engage in social activities, relate to other people, and acquire a style of life that is fundamentally social in nature. According to Adler, each person is born with the capacity to develop his or her own social interest. Social interest is a person's ability to interact in a cooperative way with people that leads to a healthy society. In this way, people develop a sense of belonging and also tend to contribute to others in the society. While a person is born with social interest, it must be nurtured and developed along the way. An individual's personality will be primarily shaped by how she or he engages in social activities and also develops the social interests. After the household and family, the school becomes a primary setting in shaping one's social interests and personality. Then, the counselors and teachers take on the role of assisting students to acquire and develop a healthy social interest. Based on the Adlerian principle, this includes helping students to belong, feel valued, develop positive self-worth, and do not feel discouraged. Personality is also formed by the choices people make to satisfy their needs. These needs affect a person's behavior because, according to Adlerian principles, all behavior is purposive and goal-directed. Therefore, people act in ways that meet their needs and develop their perception of social interest. Before elaborating on effective democratic methods and implications involved, it is necessary to understand Alfred Adler's model of humanity. Each educator's approach to the educational process is based on the concept of human nature. Some key concepts are defined and summarized as follows. Human beings are social beings and having insatiable goal to belong, to find a place in the society. Students' behavior is a sign of the ways and means by which they strive to be important, although they themselves may be unaware of the purpose of their behavior. Students' choices and actions taken may be based on faulty assumptions about themselves and life. Their behavior may appear inappropriate as they attempt to find significance. Behavior is purposeful. Recommended methods for dealing with students' behavior make sense only if we can understand or recognize the purpose of that behavior. Viewing a child through the labels such as hyperactive, learning disabled, or mentally retarded is of no use in helping discover more feasible alternatives. Human beings are biased in their perception of the world and will follow what may be called private logic or unique reasoning, which determines the course of action one takes. Students are sensitive to the social atmosphere they are engaged in and will perform early experiments with it, seeking what they want. Through this process of experimentation and growth, they integrate early experiences and develop goals accordingly. By the age of 5, a child's lifestyle is formed and he or she has drawn general conclusion about the best way to face the situation or problems that the life has to offer for them. Students strive for superiority in order to overcompensate for feelings of inferiority. By observation, trial and error, students overcompensate and in doing so, draw their own conclusions about their life and where they fit in. The benefit of using Adlerian theory is that it is very adaptive and can be used with almost anyone at any time. It teaches people that they control their own fate, and the emphasis of this theory focuses on personality, birth order, individual life choices, and social interests. Thank you.